This is a super bouncy ball that I got from the shops. This is a super bouncy ball that I made at home. Okay, so that was super not fun at all. But I reckon I can change the recipe to make it bounce a bit better. Are you ready? Then let's get science. The homemade recipe uses three main ingredients. A borax solution, made by mixing 2 tablespoons of warm water and 1/2 teaspoon of borax, Elmer's glue, and corn flour. A common recipe says to add 1 tablespoon of glue, 1 tablespoon of corn flour, and 1/2 teaspoon of the borax solution to a bowl. Wait for 15 seconds before stirring and mixing the ingredients together. You can add a few drops of food coloring to make the bouncy balls colorful. Once the ingredients lose their stickiness, roll it into a ball and see how well it bounces. Okay, that didn't work that well. I'm gonna try changing the recipe to see what makes the ball bounce the highest. Here's the plan. First, I kept all of the recipe the same, but tried different amounts of corn flour and glue. Next, I made the bouncy balls again, but this time used different amounts of borax solution. I dropped all of these from a height of 1 meter. These are the heights reached by the bouncy balls made with 1/2 teaspoon of borax solution. Only one recipe without borax solution formed a ball, and this is how high it bounced. These are the heights reached by the bouncy balls made with 1 teaspoon of borax solution. And these are the heights reached by the bouncy balls made with 2 teaspoons of borax solution. So what did we find out? This is the height reached by the ball made using the original recipe. All of these bouncy balls bounced higher than that ball, but this one is the best. It bounced almost 5 times higher. So how does this compare to a bouncy ball bought from a store? Let's not worry about that. Now you know how to use these ingredients to make the best bouncy balls. Once you make it, put it in a Ziploc bag to stop it from drying out. This is just really thick slime, so it flattens out over time. Before you go to use it, simply roll it into a ball again. Thank you for watching this episode. Let me know on Instagram if you try this one. I hope you have fun making your own bouncy balls, and I'll see you next time on Silly Science with Simon.